Honorable Speaker and Honorable Members, Kurumjari, I welcome you all to the 7th session of the 11th Manipur Legislative Assembly and the very first session for the year 2019. The new year brings with it renewed hopes and aspirations for the people. I wish coming of the Vasant Ritu ushers in the spring of renewed commitment, resolve, and determination towards fulfilling collectively the shared vision for a better and prosperous Manipur. Honorable members, the vibrant diversity and proud tradition of our state have always inspired us all to continuously work for inclusive development and common welfare of the people of the state. My government strongly believes in the principle in letter and spirit and doing our best to bring communal harmony with inclusive development. My government bridges the emotional and developmental gaps between hill and valley areas without any discrimination and with the active participation of various communities of the state. My government has also established an investment facilitation center to enable single window project clearance process for promoting investment in the state. Law and order, justice delivery. My government is committed to protect the human rights and prevent any excesses by security forces. The State Human Rights Commission, which was non-functional for nearly 9 long years, has been re-established and made functional in order to facilitate resolutions of disputes in an amicable way. The Alternate Dispute Resolution Center is made fully functional. My government has strengthened the Office of the Public Prosecutor by recruiting 7 more assistant public prosecutors to ensure timely disposal of pending cases. Honorable members, my government strongly believes that participation of the people is equally important in maintaining law and order. Towards achieving this objective, my government has started community policing at the level of all police stations, which has yielded substantial result. Finance and planning. Honorable members, my government is committed to enhancing state's own resources and ensuring fiscal consolidation so that public investment and growth are not undetermined. During the period, fiscal deficit in gross state domestic product ratio reduced to 1.13 percentage points, giving fiscal headroom to raise additional resources for accelerating the development momentum in the state. The state-owned revenue collection has registered a growth of 28% in 2017-18 over 2016-17. Intimidation of goods, implementation of goods and services tax has improved tax collection with increased compliance by taxpayers. My government's initiative in bringing about transparency and fairness in public procurement has widely been recognized. I am happy to inform this August House that recently Manipur was awarded by the Government of India as the best performing state in e-procurement implementation in the Northeast. Under non-lapsable central pool of resources, we secured an assistance of rupees 79 crore and 15 lakh this year for 8 new projects and 10 ongoing projects. The allocation of funds under Northeast Special Infrastructure Development Scheme is increased to ₹194.95 crore. My government is successful in getting approval for a new scheme called Hill Area Development Program. This year, with an outlay of ₹90 crore from Ministry of Donor for infrastructure development of Temelong and Nonay district with the support of the Ministry of Donor. Four projects costing ₹69.92 crore under Social and Infrastructure Development Fund has been taken up in the remote hill area for infrastructure development and communication and water supply sectors. In addition, my Ministry of Donor has earmarked ₹26.86 crore this year as central assistance for rebuilding totally washed away of the damaged infrastructure during flood that occurred in the year 2017. Under Border Area Development Program, 224 works have been approved for the year 2018-19 for comprehensive development of the border area. 6 model villages and 1 model village is each district is being taken up. Tribal affairs, minorities, SC, OBC welfare. Honorable member, for growth and development to be sustainable, it must be inclusive. My government is extending assistance to 2,708 ST families under the various development schemes. 2,574 ST families are being provided CGI sheets. Altogether, 77,000 ST students have been granted pre-matric scholarship and post-matric scholarship. As committed, my government has constructed and inaugurated the women's market, IMA market, at Ukrul, Chandel, Temelong, Churachandpur, Senapati, Kankopki, and Jiribam. Transit accommodation for doctors, teachers, etc. are being constructed at 17 locations in the Hill District against a target of 19 construction of barrack type quarters for primary teachers in the 6 autonomous district council and 1 Eklavya model residential school at Mantri Pantha in Chandel district is also being taken up. To provide medical facilities to tribal people in the interior hill areas, my government has established 3 health centers at Thingpokkol in Churachandpur district, Chamu in Ukrul district, and Impa in Temelong district. In order to enable focus attention, my government has established fully functional separate departments by bifurcating the erstwhile Department for Minorities and other backward classes into Department of Minority Affairs and Department of Welfare of OBC and SC. My government is committed to providing a scholarship to a target of 47,000 students belonging to these communities during 2018-19. Similarly, 7,000 minority students will be provided. Remedial coaching, skill training will be provided to 1,000 beneficiaries in bamboo craft and silk yarn reeling. Under Pradhan Mantri Jan Vikas Yojana, about ₹100 crore have been approved by the Ministry of Minority Affairs for various projects such as construction of Sadbhavna Mandap, upgradation of the school building, toilets, hostels, etc. within the year 2018-19. Food security. Honorable members, under the National Food Security Act, 23,39,435 beneficiaries belonging to AAY and priority household have been registered. Online allocation has been achieved for all districts and new genuine beneficiaries are being identified. Food Corporation of India, Godown at Swambhang, with its capacity of 1,000 metric tons, has recently inaugurated construction of additional FCI godown in Thobal, Bishnupur, Temelong, and Churachandpur has already started, and on completion and storage capacity of FCI in Manipur would be increased to 56,690 metric ton. Education. My government is committed to ensure inclusive and equitable quality education in the state. To streamline the function of the schools and optimizing use of the resources, at major exercise to restructure and rationalize government school by way of amalgamation has been taken up in order to ensure that there is no out-of-school children in the state. My government has launched a new scheme, Lari Tamhal Asi, no child left behind under the scheme. Out-of-school children in the age group of 15-18 years are identified and admitted in formal schools. My government has further launched School Swagmanthasi, an initiative under Go to Village mission in order to garner the lost public trust in government school under the mission Comprehensive Quality Development of an Identified Government School in each assembly constituency, which will include introduction of pre-nursery classes, ensuring teacher availability on sustainable basis, filling up of infrastructure gap, introduction of smart classes, etc., will be taken up with provision of funds for the same. To improve the quality of education, 25,000 untrained elementary teachers and another 790 elementary teachers are sent for diploma and short-term courses. A component of the regional history of Manipur was introduced in the syllabus of history subject for the class 12. Under the Rashtriya Madhyamik Shiksha Abhiyan, 182 junior high schools have been upgraded to high school. Vocational classes for class 9 were made functional in 42 schools in 8 different trades. To project and promote the Manipurian tribal languages, my government has taken up various activities, translation of all available Manipuri textbooks from class 1 to graduation from Bengali script into Meitei Maik has been done. Standardization of Manipuri terminologies for 16 subjects has been completed. My government is committed to improve technical education in the state. Toward this objective, the Manipur International University Bill 2018 was passed by the Manipur Legislative Assembly. The Dhanmanjari University also started functioning from the academic session 2018-19 with 13 new postgraduate programs. Foundation stone was also laid for setting up a government engineering college at Hyderabad under Rashtriya Uchchatar Shiksha Abhiyan. Power sector. Honorable members, Manipur has been able to achieve its long cherished dream of adopting 400 kilowatt system with a successful charging of Silchar Imphal 400 kV DC transmission line on 25th December 2018. It will ensure enough available transmission capacity to cater to the power requirement of the state for the 9-15 years. For the next 15 years, during the last 22 months, 732-33 kilowatt substation and 1033-11 kV substation have been commissioned and operationalized. All present at 21-31 by 11 kV substation and 2 132-33 KV substation under various funding agencies are also being implemented. About 2,000 kilometers wide network of fiber optics cables are being laid across the state to gather real-time information from the substation for real-time power supply management. My government has been giving renewed trust to the generation sector. Reassessment of the small hydropower power potential of the state with the latest available technologies has been completed recently. Although 32 number of projects having total capacity of more than 300 megawatt have been identified, my government is also trying to develop two medium scale hydropower projects, nearly 66 megawatt Loktak downstream hydroelectric project and 75 megawatt Nangli Bund hydroelectric project for availing extension funding. As on January 2019, all the 2,582 census villages in Manipur have been electrified, although 98 unelectrified villages were electrified through solar lighting system. Electricity connection was provided to 1,02,000 unelectrified households under Pradhan Mantri Sahaj Bijli Har Ghar Yojana. 3,42,000 prepaid meters were installed, and efforts are being made to replace all the naked all-aluminium cable with aerial bunched cable to reduce theft. These efforts have translated to reduce in aggregate technical and commercial loss from 44.20% in 2015-16 to about 22.43% in the current year. Agriculture, allied activities and natural resources. Honorable Member, the state has prepared strategies for doubling the farmers' income by 2022. Benefits under the Pradhan Mantri Fiscal Bima Yojana has been extended to all the subdivisions of the state, benefiting 9,465 farmers. Under the Mission Organic Value Chain Development, an area of 2,000 hectares have been brought under organic cultivation of blade-scented rice, chakhao. Under this mission, more than 20,000 farmers across Manipur have been registered for organic certification. Several MOS and MOUs have been signed with buyers in the last 1 year to promote organic commodities under the Organic Manipur brand. Three primary processing units for ginger and turmeric developed by Central Agriculture University Imphal have been set up in Firzwal district. One integrated processing unit has also been approved and sanctioned through Northeast Development Finance Corporation Limited, which will undertake processing of all organic products. During 2018-19, one cold storage of 1,000 metric ton capacity has been set up and inaugurated under Mission for Integrated Development in Horticulture. I am happy to share that India Javik Award 2018 was awarded to Department of Horticulture and Soil Conservation as the best performing agency for the North and Northeastern state by International Competence Center for Organic Agriculture. My government is committed to sustainable development of natural resources in state. During the year, plantation of over 9,731 hectares of forest area was taken up in increased forest cover. Around 30 lakh seedlings were distributed to the public during 69 Vana Mahotsav Festival 2018 to promote clean and healthy environment. assistance was given to 4,000 eco-club schools and 100 eco-club colleges established in the state under the National Green Corps program. Viticulture, veterinary and animal husbandry. Honorable members, we are aware that we are importing half of our requirement of the fish for daily consumption. In order to bring self-sufficiency, my government is making efforts to augment fish production by providing quality, affordable fish feed. A fish feed mill with a production capacity of 170 kilograms per hour is being established at Lumpfield. Fishery loans were distributed to fish farmers. Loktak Livelihood Mission has been launched for attainment of the self-sufficiency in fish production by 2020. The mission also seeks to convert the fundis in the Loktak Lake into organic fertilizer and thus doubles up an income generation and cleansing mechanism for the lake. With an objective for doubling farmers' income, 2,700 poultry farmers, 900 piggery farmers, and 450 goatry farmers will be assisted under National Livelihood Mission, Livestock Mission during this year. Central Poultry Farm at Kumbang has been rejuvenated with the introduction of 2,000 low-input technology birds and one incubator with capacity to produce 30,000 chicks per month under Rashtriya Krishi Vikas Yojana. Concrete wall fencing is being constructed around the pony sanctuary at the foothills of Marjing with an endeavor to protect the Manipuri pony and preserve the associated culture. Water resources and management. Honorable member, water management is key to economic stability of the state. The work at Dolaithibal Paraj project has been completed and commissioned. My government is committed to early completion of the Thobal multipurpose project, which is targeted for completion in all respects by the end of this year. Dredging and re-sanctioning work of the major rivers in the around the Imphal city has appreciably increased. The carrying capacity of the rivers has thus reducing the menace of flood devastation to a greater extent. Development of Nemfelpat water body, Wetpot Iron Nala upper and lower has already been started to preserve and project critical wetlands in the state. Irrigation potential of 12,904 hectares is being targeted for creation under the 102 minor irrigation scheme in 2018-19. Rainwater harvesting schemes taken up in Tamilong, Kankopki, Chandel, Kamjong, and Churachandpur districts are targeted for completion by March 2019 to conserve water for irrigation. Lining of 9 reservoirs with geotextile material has been taken up. Water supply. Honorable members, for improving the water supply system in Imphal area, integrated water supply for Imphal planning area is being taken up. Phase 1 of the project is completed. Phase 2, costing rupees 175 crores and 81 lakh under Atal Mission for rejuvenation and urban transformation for replacement of the pipe network under Imphal municipal area is targeted for completion by March 2020. construction of water treatment plant of 45 million liters per day at Chinkaching will withdraw water from the Thobal Dam is ongoing, and we have achieved substantial progress. In order to attain the target of water for all by 2022, my government has submitted 3 proposals for externally aided funding by New Development Bank amounting to a total of ₹2,640 crores and 30 lakhs, consisting of Greater Imphal Planning Area Phase 3 of ₹990 crores and 46 lakhs, water supply in 28 other towns worth ₹339 crores and 84 lakhs, and water supply in rural areas of Manipur worth ₹1,310 crores. These projects have been recommended by the Government of India to New Development Bank and are in the process of construction by NDB. The Imphal Sewage Phase 1 is now completed. Trial runs are underway and will be commissioned by December 2019. The state has been declared open defecation free status a year ahead on 2 October 2018. Healthcare. Honorable members, good healthcare and wellness of the people is a priority of my government. Health projection by providing cashless medical cover to AAY families, disabled and widows for up to ₹2 lakh per family per year continue to be provided under the Chief Minister Ki Hashkingi Thangban scheme. Newspaper hawkers and journalists have also been included in eligible beneficiaries under CMHT. My government is also implementing Ayushman Bharat, under which beneficiaries identified through socio-economic caste census will be provided medical cover up to ₹5 lakh per family per year. To cater to the medical emergencies in the hill areas, 10 advanced life support ambulances are developed. 244 doctors have been recruited through MPSC, and 65% of them have been posted to the hill district to cover the chronic shortage of the doctors in hill areas. To address the shortage of specialists in the state health service, the recruitment age of the specialists, the retirement age of the specialist doctors have increased to 65 years. Generic medicines are made available in 26 health institutions. 53 diagnostic tests have been made free at Jawaharlal Nehru Institute of Medical Sciences and Regional Institute of Medical Sciences Hospital. Free dialysis for BPL families is also available at GenIMS. To further expand diagnostic facilities at the level of the primary health center, 85 motorcycle-based mobile laboratory systems are being procured to cover remote and inaccessible villages. My government is trying to introduce air ambulance service in the state to establish a 100-bedded cancer hospital at GenIMS and a 60-bedded state mental hospital in Imphal West District. TB hospital at Kairau Wangkhem, Imphal East, was inaugurated last year under Mission Indradhanush. 95% of the children between 2 years, were 0 to 2 years, were immunized during this year. Connectivity. Honorable members, for inclusive socio-economic development and sustainable growth, physical connectivity is vital. Helicopter services were launched on 19 September 2018 in Manipur under the MHA subsidy scheme connecting Imphal to Moray, Tamilong and Jiribam. After reviving, the Manipur State Transport Services were further expanded so as to cover six more districts with the introduction of additional six buses. Loktak Inland Water Transport Project Phase 2 has been approved by the Ministry of Shipping and Construction, has already started. Project profile for Barak Inland Water Transport Project for development of 65 kilometer Barak extension stretch has been submitted. Considering the limited resources of the state, my government is actively pursuing externally aided projects with funding from multiple banks like ADB, World Bank, JICA, etc., for development of road transstructure. At the moment, two road projects, Thoba Kasum Kulin via Bishnupur, at a cost of ₹475 crores under Northeast State Roads Investment Program, and Imphal Khangchuk Tamilong Road at a cost of ₹1,411 crores under South Asia Sub-Regional Economic Cooperation Road Connectivity Investment Program with assistance from ADB are under implementation. My government has also proposed to Union Government for conversion of seven important state roads as national highways. Important junctions in the Imphal city are being remodeled and footover bridges are being constructed to minimize conflict of vehicles and pedestrians as immediate interim solution at a cost of ₹18 crores and 48 lakhs. Proposal for construction of Imphal Ring Road and elevated highways within the Imphal city at a projected cost of ₹1,148 crores and ₹2,350 crores under externally aided project to provide a permanent and sustainable solution have been agreed in principle by the Union Government. Proposal for reconstruction and improvement of important state road at a cost of ₹2,810 crores was assistance which from ADB have been proposed. 108 4.92 kilometers of national highway under the state PWD are being improved at the cost of ₹894 crores and 74 lakhs, and improvement of the 37 numbers of state roads under Central Road Fund at the cost of ₹260 crores is also being taken up. Under NEC, due importance have also been accorded to all the all-round development and reducing regional imbalance between hill and valley. A number of important projects have been taken up, which include Tamilong Temai Road, Kankoki Temai Road, improvement of Bishnupur Nanguba Road, improvement of NH-202 to Chebang, development of road from Moadok to Kolan District Roads, construction of interstate truck terminus at Imphal Sikmai, one road in Ukhrul under NEC, funding is targeted for completion by 2019-20. Three roads have been approved, namely Jalangbong to Khezurkhono, Nagaland via Sankital Road of 20 kilometers connecting Ukhrul and Senapati district. Hengal Thinku Timahmukh Road of 15 kilometer length is Jurachandpur district, and Khamjong to Kongkhen Thana of 40 kilometer length leading to international border Myanmar. under Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana, 419 kilometers of road have been constructed as on 31st January 2019, connecting 28 eligible habitations. So far, 6,668 kilometers of road has been constructed, providing rural connectivity to 522 habitations. During 2018-19, Ministry of Rural Development, Government of India has sanctioned 109 roads and 27 bridges at a cost of ₹971 crore and 52 lakhs at Tier 1. Urban planning and development. My government is committed to reducing the functional bottlenecks in delivering various services. We have established Citizen Felicitation Center at Imphal to provide various documents and services. My government is going to provide Visa Application Center in the proposed Citizen Facilitation Center, whereby people can submit their visa application online from Imphal itself. This Citizen Felicitation Center is completed and will be inaugurated in the next few days. The existing solid waste treatment plant was upgraded to waste to energy plant. The plant will start producing electricity by the end of this month. Under NLCRP, total cost of rupees 13 crore and 52 lakhs was sanctioned for Cluster B solid waste management project. Under Smart City project, the design for improvement of the Tangal Bazaar, Pauna Bazaar, and development of cycle track along Imphal River for Saninjong Thong to Minthong is completed. All 27 urban local bodies were declared as ODF. Kakching Municipal Council was awarded cleanest city town in Northeast India. Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana scheme is being implemented in the urban areas to provide housing for all. About 26,348 houses are approved and require funds for the relief. Rural development. Construction of houses under the Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana Gramin is in good progress. An additional target of 91,000 houses under the scheme has been allotted to the state. Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Generation Scheme has benefited 5,60,000 families till January 2019, and during the current financial year, 51,20,000 persons mandates were generated to provide employment to rural poor. Social welfare. Honorable members, my government is committed to inclusive development and welfare of the aged, disabled and the marginalized. Under the Chief Minister Ki Shothar Bang Singhi Thang Bang scheme, about 4,000 different able persons are being provided benefits in the form of care, given allowances, scholarship, and free travel concessions. 1,15,974 beneficiaries are being provided old age pensions under National Social Assistance Program and Manipur Old Age Pension Scheme, aimed to cover another 30,000 in the coming financial year under Go to Village mission. To strengthen Anganwadi centers, my government is providing drinking water and toilet facilities in the Anganwadi center. Smartphones are being provided under National Nutrition Mission to all the Anganwadi workers to ensure proper monitoring and supervision of the services being provided. I'm very happy to inform that Manipur has won 3 national awards under Poshan Abhiyan, Best Implementation District in Chandel, best field functionaries for individual excellence to Asha and Anganwadi workers, and best field functionaries for joint activities to Anganwadi worker, Asha and auxiliary nurse, midwife, A&M. Under Pradhan Mantri Vandana Yojana, cash incentive has also been provided to 7,000 women. My government is committed to prevention of trafficking and to rescue and rehabilitation of victims of trafficking. Recently, around 150 women and 30 men were rescued from trafficking. 15 more one-stop centers in each district of the state are being established to deal with the menace of drug addiction in the state. A state drug policy is being prepared. Nesha Chadaba Manipur Ohe Hans scheme has been launched to create awareness among the students and masses for a drug-free society. Illegal drugs and plantation continue to be seized and destroyed. Labour welfare and employment generation. My government is committed to creating self-employment opportunities through skill development and training under the various schemes of the government. 3 ITIs were upgraded and construction of 2 new ITIs is taken up in Sikmai and Gangpokti. The government of India has approved establishment of another 2 new ITIs at Freswal and Noni district. To provide care, protection and social security for buildings and other construction workers in the state, beneficiaries have been extended assistance for education, accident and natural death, medical and maternity care. Steps to revise and update the unemployment figures on the live register of the 17th employment exchange in the state has been installed. The total live register candidates has been reduced from 8,03,123 to 3,63,475. Manipur Startup Scheme is one of the most ambitious employment generation scheme conceived and launched by the state government. Its objective is to create a vibrant startup ecosystem to nurture innovation, encourage entrepreneurship, and to create employment opportunities under Manipur Startup Scheme. Round 1, 334 startups under different categories have been benefited through disbursement of loan and subsidy component. Selection process for round 2 of the scheme is now going on. A total budgetary provision of ₹60 crore for round 1 and round 2 is made available for the implementation of this scheme. Textile, commerce and industry. Honorable members, Manipur is literally the gateway to India, to Southeast Asia. To boost border management and trade infrastructure, the integrated checkpost at Mohre, constructed at the cost of ₹136 crore, was recently inaugurated by Honorable Prime Minister on the 4th January 2019. Mohre has been notified as immigration point for entry and exit with valid documents. To promote micro and small entrepreneurs, DPRs for setting up common facility center for social and food processing, spices and food processing, Churachandpur for ₹6.66 crore. Common Facility Centre and Greater Imphal for Jewellery Cluster for ₹3.29 crore, and Common Facility Centre at Churachandpur for wood carpentry cluster for rupees 4 crore and 38 lakhs have been approved by the screening committee of micro small enterprise cluster development program in the Ministry of MSME, Government of India, and final approval is awaited. To promote and develop the handloom textile sector, my government has been supporting the weavers and artisans through doorstep delivery of handloom yarn at subsidized rates, as well as arrangements for the buyback of the finished products, setting up urban heart skill upgradation of 750 weavers and artisans, and distribution of 1,815 fly shuttle looms. The development of handloom and textile had organized a hugely successful Manipur International Textile Expo 2018 during 5th to 15th November 2018 at Manipur Trade and Expo Center, Lamboi Khom Jong Khom. A modern terracotta project is also being established at Tongai Jau, which has been traditionally renewed for the traditional pottery production. My government has also started apparel and garment production unit at Lam Koi Hong Kong, which has been started exporting textile products outside Manipur with plans for 7 export abroad. 1 EN spin with an outlay of rupees 21 crore and 53 lakh will be established as project management complex Senapat, Sangaipat, under the Mission for Economic Empowerment of Traditional Artisans and Craftsmen, entrepreneurs and artisans engaged in traditional arts and crafts of the state are being groomed and empowered with e-marketing facilities to fill the gap in the supply chain from marketing the traditional arts and crafts of the state. I must make a special mention for my government's hugely successful hosting of the 3rd World Bamboo Workshop at Imphal. For the first time in Asia, there is delegates from as many as 34 countries participated with demonstration workshop and interactive session on the latest technologies, products and information on bamboo were showcased. Tourism. Honorable members, Manipur offers huge potential for growth in tourism sector with improved tourism infrastructure and security scenario. In recent years, tourist inflow increased by 13.15% in 2017-18 over that in 2016-17. The Manipur Sangai Festival 2018 was organized on a much larger scale and at multiple venues. The Cherry Blossom Festival in Mao was included as part of the festival. The age-old traditional culture in the and the hospitality of Ukhrul district was showcased as part of the second state-level Shrui Lili Festival. Other festivals like Orange Festival, Barak Festival, Kutlui Negaini, Mira On Hu Chong Ba, Lemon Festival, Pineapple Festival, Amur Falcon Festival, etc., were also supported by my government. The Margin Polo Complex at Haigang has been made more tourist friendly with inauguration of a restaurant, information come tourist hall, public toilet facilities and eco lodge. The development of Northeast Tourist Circuit, Imphal and Kongjom under Swadesh Darshan scheme was inaugurated and made Manipur the first state to inaugurate projects taken up under the said scheme in India. Information technology and science and technology. Honorable members, various projects are being implemented under National E-Government Plan towards efficient and transparent governance. 878 common service centres have been established to provide government services to the citizens. Wireless internet connectivity, 14 district headquarters of Manipur has been provided and the existing SWAN network strengthened. With the successful migration of the Manipur state data centre to cloud platform, Manipur has been recognised as a forerunner in adopting cloud technology and awarded the India Express Award in cloud technology category. To provide creativity and inspire young students, one innovative hub has been established at Manipur Science Centre, Takiapat. Sports. Manipur is a powerhouse of sports in the country. To strengthen sport infrastructure, work for installation of floodlights at the main stadium and hockey stadium at the Khumman Lampat Sports Complex, Imphal, and construction of artificial football turf at Imphal West is being taken up. In the 63rd National Inter-School Tournament, the state team won 60 gold, 46 silver and 57 bronze medals. In the recent concluded rural sports under Khelo India Youth Games, the state team participated in 9 different sports disciplines and won 32 medals. Arts and culture. My government is committed to nurture, promote and preserve the rich and diverse cultural heritage of Manipur. 2 new constructed bronze statues of Maharaja Narsingh and Hirachandra were unveiled. Cultural troops from the state participated in the 5th Silk Road International Art Festival in China, Surin International Cultural Exchange Program in Thailand. Vigilant media is vital for our democracy. The government continues to provide financial assistance under Manipur State Journalist Welfare Scheme. Monthly pension is being provided to retired journalists and widows of the journalists. Maintenance grants are provided annually to Manipur Press Club, all Manipur Working Journalists Union and Manipur Hill Journalists Union. For better mobility to ensure effective functioning of the field officials, 61 new vehicles were handed over to SPs, SDOs and OCs. Syllabus for Manipur Civil Service Combined Competitive Exam was modified to harmonize with the Civil Service Exam of the UPSC. Conclusion. Honorable members, Manipur is blessed with tremendous natural and human resources. My government is committed to realize the full untapped potential in the state effectively and efficiently while ensuring that the process is inclusive and sustainable towards this objective. I look forward to the wholehearted support and commitment of all the honorable members. Thank you and Jai Hind.